such a great reflex catch. I suppose a little bit of good fortune attached to it for Matthew Hayden, but he is a good slipper. And although he didn't get it cleanly the first time, it was a terrific effort to have his hand in the position in any case.
And they were pleased to see the back of Hoggard because he can be a nuisance.
Gosh, that's a great catch. Superb athletic fielding. And it's done for Peterson, but what a good innings.
Most magnificent catch from Damien Martin, sprinting round from deep mid-wicket, full-length dive.
That is really well bowled. I think you'll find it was the slider that has gone across the left-hander. And it was a sharp catch. That ball went really quickly.
Good variation from Warne. Yeah, it was a sharp catch. Nice sort of catching height to Hayden, but it's just brilliant from Warne, really. He's found an area in which he's asked questions of Triscothic every ball.
Yes, and that's the slider to end all sliders. It certainly ended Ian Bell. That was beautifully bowled. All those big leg breaks, all that great turn and spin and jump, and a straight ball is done for him.
Easy enough for the umpire.
Oh, that's out, caught behind, big neck. Trying to smash it through the offside field, a disappointed Flintoff. Just backing away a little bit, trying to smash, a little bit of extra bounce there for Warne, and that is the end of Freddie Flintoff.
Well, it looked to me as if he set him up with a couple of that did turn, Lakesman's. This didn't, it just sort of ran on a bit quicker, just comes out of the hand, yeah, definitely just run on quicker, that, it's on to him. Great catch. Good catch there by the wicketkeeper.
That's out. That is the straight one, the slider. And I think you'll see on the replay that Harmison didn't get outside the line of the stumps and the ball was going straight on. A first baller, something for the primary club.
That's right, he'll be presented with a very special tie with stumps all over the place. Here we go. And well, you can see there, bang, middle and leg. No wonder they were all in the air.
Put England in, and so far, it hasn't worked. Until that very moment. And what a wonderful change of pace that was. That's the real art of leg spinning. A really quick delivery.
Well, it's a marvellous piece of bowling from Shane Warne. Spinning it out of that rough. Quicker pace, as Richie Beno said, but I think Andrew Strauss is going to be disappointed with himself.
Out! This time, Bowden says, you got to go.
That looked as though it would have to be very, very close. It was a quicker ball, looked like the straight one, and it's pitched in line, and that, I reckon, would have hit middle and off.
Fly. The slider straight out of the front of the hand.
Deceived Harmison here, got it very full. It was almost through him as he tried to play it to leg. A bit puzzled. That's a wonderful picture, that.
And Edgbaston stands to acclaim a thrilling batting display.
Which came to an end soon after that when Matthew Hoggard was LBW to Shane Warne.
From Shane Warne. Magnificent piece of bowling from Warne. He's made a few batsmen look a bit foolish over the years, and there's no disgrace in Andrew Strauss looking a bit foolish, but he did here.
What's that hit? Giving it out. Now, Peterson doesn't look happy. Peterson will reckon it hit his chest or some other part of his body, I wonder. But, Tony, you thought it was out immediately.
Well, it looked to me as if it hit the glove, but he's shaking his head. I don't like the fact that he's looking up at the screen. It means this means he's a little unsure as well.
Now, let's have a look. Seems to miss the glove, then clip the thigh before going up into the chest and hitting the elbow and dropping down to the ground. What's happened here? Ow! Just a little thin one. What a bowler. A fantastic bowler. Ripping spin. The bell didn't do too much wrong.
Beautifully taken as well. Boy, he's very good with those gloves. There's the little edge. You can see the little rattle of the bat there.
Neat. Made him play at that. Instead of the ball being down round about the line of leg stump, he has got it about middle and leg and produced the defensive stroke from Giles. And Hayden has taken the catch.
Got his revenge, Shane Warne. Ashley Giles, of course, did for Warne when Warne was batting, and now Warne has got this revenge. A beautifully pitched leg break, lots of side spin. Giles prodding forward and succeeding in only edging a simple catch through to Matthew Hayden.
Toss, and well,
slider from Warne, very straight, and hit the pad. Did it hit the bat? Ricky Ponting took an excellent catch at Silly Point, and fancy that's how Rudy Kirtson gave Stephen Harmison out. He seemed to prod it back pad straight to Ricky Ponting. Good sharp catch, and five wickets for Shane Warne.
A bowled in. That's the end of that. Shane Warne has eventually got his man. So Warne ends up with 6 for 46. And he's now on 599 wickets. A little clap there for Flintoff from Warne. This is the one. You try to smash that into the stands as well. Hit middle and leg. And the end of a very good knock from Flintoff.
What's that done? Now then, yes, out. 600 test match wickets for Shane Warne. What a moment.
The whole ground is standing, but I fancy it's not so much for Marcus Trescothick, but for Shane Warne. 600th wicket has come off slightly unorthodox fashion, off the back of Trescothick's bat, onto Adam Gilchrist's knee and up into his gloves. And the end of Marcus Trescothick, and what a moment for the great leg spinner.
That's in the air, and this is going to be out if they catch it. Langer's got it. Well, he tried to hit it a little wide of mid-on. I think he was going for sort of mid-wicketish, and that turned a little bit. And you've got to be a little careful about doing that to Warne. On a good day for Warne, those always go straight up. Look at the delivery again.
Well, it was a lovely delivery. Got it up in the air with a bit of overspin and a bit of dip. And Flintoff, as Tony Gregg said, looking for that straight mid-wicket area, trying to bunt him over there for six, as he did at Edgbaston.
Yeah. And that's gone. Solid catch taken by Matthew Hayden at first slip. So there's the ninth wicket. Exactly what Australia wanted straight after the lunch break. An early breakthrough.
Well, this was a textbook leg spinner. Just run up, get the batsman playing forward, spin the ball, get the outside edge, and a simple catch to first slip.
There he goes, and cleaned up. Right through the gate there from Shane Warne. Brilliant piece of bowling yet again. A man who's got his 600th test wicket yesterday, and now he's got 603.
Well, he deserves it, really. Just throw it a little bit wider into the rough there. Bowler's footmarks. Mm-hmm. Just tempting the left-hander to have a swipe at it.
Steve Buckner's going to ask the umpire squarely. He needs to ask him something here.
The question is, did the inside edge go onto Strauss's boot and pop up to slip?
It definitely goes onto the foot. That is what Steve Buckner wanted to know. Alim Dar couldn't tell him, so they're able to refer it to the third umpire. And the third umpire will be able to tell Steve Buckner precisely what happened.
Should give it out. Inside edge straight onto the boot and popping up to Matthew Hayden.
The minute that it hit the pad, Michael Slater had his finger up. It just looked right.
It just went straight on. And then I heard the Shane Warne giggle and I thought, well, he thinks it's out as well. You just see the ball go straight on here. There is a commitment down the pitch from Giles, but no problem with that one.
Harmison is out. No, I thought he was going to be given in.
It was the flatter one, the quicker one. And Harmison in the end was like a tripod who had lost a third leg. Gonski. There's an edge. Good catch from Adam Gilchrist. He stayed down on that one, followed the ball, and straight into the mitts. Gone. I reckon that's a bad pad. It is. The first one for Australia, and the first ball from Shane Warne. It's the start of the sixth over, and it's 32 for one.
I was just about to say that I thought Trescothick should get the sweep, the lap, the slog out, not be playing and propping and copping with all that rough there, because it's much harder for left-handers, as we can see. Pad, bat, clear as a bell. Very good catch, stayed down, didn't move.
Great bowling. Fantastic cricketer this guy is. Matthew Hayden takes the catch. Warne has two. And the butterflies are suddenly in England's camp.
And he got some drift. Vaughan looked to work that gap at mid-wicket and got a leading edge to Matthew Hayden. It's brilliant piece of thinking and bowling from Shane Warne.
Oh, he's got him! He's got him! I think there was a little edge on that one. A little glance to the square leg umpire. And, well, there's a celebration taking place on the one end by all the Australians. The batsman's not going.
I think that the umpires here want to know whether it carried. Let's just have a look. There it is. There is the edge onto the pad. No doubt in my mind whatsoever that that was caught. None at all.
It's in the air. This is going to be out. Kasprovich won't drop this. This is all over. That's it. Another down. The pressure has got to Garen Jones.
Enticing the big lofted stroke, and the spin was too much. Kasprovich, he was waiting for a while. This is thinking time, but he was positive. In she goes.
Fantastic catch. That is so difficult to do. Magnificent cricket this from the Australians, and as so often led by Warne, but backed up by something special.
This is as good as it gets. These catches are very difficult. Just watch him move, and move very late. Wonderful catch by Hayden.
Warne is going to be cranky about that. He has got a ball that instantly he thought he could bang away on the onside. We've seen him loft the ball through that mid-wicket area occasionally, and it has just bounced a fraction more on him. Ooh, that is close. LBW, 3 for 1. That's really well bowled. Bell hadn't got to the point of realising that Warne's not turning the ball much, but that was a quicker delivery.
The ball just drifted slightly, and Bell had his pad on the line of the ball and not the bat, and it would have gone on to hit leg stump.
Bowled him! There it is, the battle's over! And Shane Warne gets his fourth. What a delivery!
Well, this was a wonderful delivery. Pitched roundabout, leg and middle, turned, hit off stump, and he's trying to whip it away through the onside. Big spin on it. I think he was so surprised, was Peterson. He couldn't believe it turned this much, or maybe that he missed it. Oh, beautiful ball. Scrape between bat and par, but it was a terrific delivery. It spun. That's big, big, big for Australia.
That's the end of that. It's a great performance from Shane Warne. A 5-wicket haul on the first day of a test match. He's in his 31st over. And best of all, he's entered the Strauss resistance. Terrific cricket from both men. The standing ovation will first go to Strauss. Played a marvellous hand today. Great athleticism in here. Simon Kadich going with his left hand, so that's a help to him. Billy Bowden makes the decision for Shane Warne. Ashley Giles stands there in disbelief. It's a roundabout a par score, not better than that.
Yes! Yeah! Oh, two noises there, and Warne has done it. Or perhaps it's a dismissal by light meter.
Well, whatever it is, it's increase the nervous tension. Watch this delivery from Shane Warne. Strauss trying to play in front of his pad because he's worried about how he got out in the first innings. And a big, thick inside edge to Simon Kadich.
Oh, that's got to be close. Oh, yes, up goes the finger. Warne has got him. Well, it was a question for me of did he get outside the line or was it going to slip down the leg side? It spun a long way. He got the benefit of the doubt last time round. Warne went up again. This time, it was the opinion of the umpire that Triscothic was in front. Let's have a look.
What a spin. Hit him on off stump. And I think this was a good decision.
That's in the air, got him, caught and bowled. He's hit it straight back to him. Caught and bowled. And look at Warne. That is a big wicket. He's been tossing it up, trying to encourage the drive. Flint offers, come into the trap, and Warne that time takes the catch.
Brilliant bowling, and a fine catch too, and the reaction will be replicated all round the ground. Drive from Flint off, slightly uppish. Good, smart, low catch from Warne. Big, big wicket that.
Is it for Collingwood? Warne is the striker again. It's a terrific catch. Ricky Ponting falling forward from silly point. Collingwood resisted over time.
It was a very good decision, wasn't it? Because it was just a little bit of glove. And Ricky Ponting taking an excellent catch, diving forward.
Yep, he's truly flown in the face of his critics. He fights and he fights. But even he occasionally has to get out. That was Shane Warne getting one around the back of his legs, and then he came in for just a bit of a kiss and a cuddle.
Straight afterwards, Steve Harmison went to Warne as well. Superb catch by Matthew Hayden. And suddenly England were all out. But they led by 341. And all the attention suddenly was on two Australians who left the field for the last time.